every member of humanity has the potential to become a member of success story of creative economy. Basically, creative economy is based on how a person uses his creative imagination to increase value of his idea. So to prove the first statement right, there has to be certain improvement, certain changes, which needs to be made in different fields. And I believe that education is one of them. And in fact, it's one of the most important fields for the development. So today I am here to present my research paper on the topic of creative economy in education field. My name is Bhargavi Madhukar Munthe. First of all, I would like to introduce my topic to you all. So when we say creative economy, by this term, we can define it as an evolving concept which builds on interplay between human creativity, ideas, and knowledge and technology. So the development or the growth of this creative economy basically depends on the people who use their creativity, creative mind, to produce an output out of their idea of whatever knowledge they have. In previous lecture also by respected Hingmere sir, he highlighted the importance of creativity. So now you must have understood the significance of creativity. But the creativity is such a thing which cannot be acquired systematically. Like it cannot be taught directly to the students. The most we can do for it is that foster a state of mind so that creativity may come to us. So education field has to create an holistic approach or an environment which will ensure that creativity is nurtured. So the basic purpose behind this paper was that I believe that education is one of the strongest tool which can be used to change the world. And it's basic foundation for development. So if we want to increase the pace or the growth of development of creative economy, first its base should be made stronger. So for that, educational or the traditional education system which we are following should be improved for, and changes should be made accordingly. The method which I followed was I analyzed current or traditional education system through different articles, research papers, along with national education policy, and came up with different 5 changes which can be brought and needs to be brought in education field in order to improve it and contribute to the creative economy. So let's have a look at them one by one. The first one is improvement should be done in post-scholastic areas. Even if a person has tremendous amount of knowledge, or if he is able to think creatively, come up with different creative ideas, it's very important that he is able to convey those ideas to the other people or make an output out of it by using technology and computers. So for this, post-scholastic areas like general knowledge, environmental education, physical education, these areas should be looked upon and given preference. So along with post-scholastic areas, soft skills and skills in ICT should be improved and brought in curriculum. Now, when I analyzed national education policy, I came across that it includes vocational training courses like gardening, pottery in school level and in college level, different kinds of internships. This will ensure that creative and critical thinking habit is created in students. So this will take care that post-scholastic areas are improved. Also, exposure to coding and computers from the 7th standard itself is written in the policy. So this will ensure that students have knowledge and technology from the school level itself. Next way is transformative leadership should be given preference. Now there are different types of leaders in our world. Some people who use coercive power on others and make present even worse for them and for whole economy. So they can be termed as poor leaders. Then we have transactional leaders who make present better by rewarding whoever has done best performance. But transformational leaders are the ones who do things differently. Like they create a vision which keeps on encouraging their team members. And they do not just pressurize their team members to achieve certain goals, but they themselves also have an authenticity in their commitment towards any goal. And they have growth mindset, not only there, but also their team members' professional as well as personal growth. So this is very important. And by all these ways, they encourage their team members and others to think creatively and innovatively, which is the need of creative economy. Third one is autonomy must be encouraged in education field. So by autonomy, we mean that a person's ability to act on his or her own values and interests. So we can define it as self-legislation or self-governance of our own. So what this will ensure that bad competition is not created. person will not have a mindset that he has to compete with others, but he will have mindset that first he has to compete with himself and develop his personality. So he will try to identify his weaknesses, his strengths, and work upon his weakness, and will get self-motivated by his strengths. So, and basically creativity requires such kind of environment where autonomy is exercised, so that the creative mind or creative imagination of the person is nurtured. So this is very important point. So national education policy includes evaluation of report card. So now, till now, it is done only by teachers. But this policy says that it will be done by peers, as well as self-evaluation will be promoted. Now, because of this, person will be able to identify his own strengths and weaknesses, and autonomy will be encouraged ultimately. Also, if peers are evaluating others, they will tell them their weaknesses along with strengths. So they will grow as a team and not compete with each other and pull down others' legs. So this will ensure two things: autonomy and team building attitude. Next one we have, education system should act as a knowledge incubator. So this is very important point, that it should provide an environment where student will be able to discover different kinds of opportunities, challenges, and he will have a mindset to take up more and more risk and bring useful output out of it. So it will also ensure that it will develop critical thinking and creativity of person. Also, in traditional education system, more importance is given to rote learning, which should be shifted to practical learning, which is need of an hour. Also, more and more research-based institutions should be given preference, so that it leads to innovations, and not only innovations, but also creative ideas. And lastly, the most important point, that is, hierarchy in educational field must be changed. That is, most of the educational institution even today follow traditional education system. So basically, hierarchy is such that science and maths field is given more importance than humanity and then arts. This is the case till now. But in the past, during industrial revolution, it was helpful. It was useful, in fact, because it was demanding such kind of person from such fields. But in today's technological culture or knowledge-based economy, all the fields must be given equal importance. And not only this, but people also should be aware about importance of all the fields and what are the career opportunities in those fields. And this should not be done after 10th or after 12th, because till then the person's mindset is developed in one way. So it should be done right from small school level. Now, in national education policy, it includes multidisciplinary education. So it says that if a person has interest in maths or in science and arts field, then he will be able to take subjects from both the fields. So this will ultimately ensure that traditional hierarchy will lose its importance and will achieve its goal. But I feel that there is challenge for this policy, that is execution of policy. Even if most of the points are included in this policy, the strengths which I discussed, but it's theoretical till now. It has to be brought in practical world. So for that, effective and efficient implementation of the policy should be done. For that, after the implementation, first, the educators who are going to implement these, who are going to teach students directly, those educators should be trained accordingly. And then after implementation, it should also be conveyed to the people, so that people are made aware about the changes and also its importance, so that they get adjusted with that new change. And now here I would like to conclude that I hope each and every one of us has understood the importance of creativity. So as basic foundation of creative economy is education field, it has to be given preference and it should be improved. More flexible curriculum should be made. Exposure to practical knowledge is must. And if all these things are done effectively, if policy is implemented efficiently, then I think that surely education system will prove to be a catalyst in growth and development of creative economy. And the very first statement I said, that each and every person has the potential to become a member of success story of creative economy, will become reality soon. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Bhargavi. You said that coding will be started in 6th, 7th standard itself. Do you think that's possible with rural schools?
Now, before pandemic, we must have thought that even the online education will not become possible in rural school. But as the situation is changing, all people are trying to adjust with that situation, because change is the only permanent thing in our world. So eventually, when change will come to us, we will try to adjust with that change. So it will not become possible in 1 or 2 days, but if we work upon it, definitely it will become possible, because now the world is like that, it's based on technology. So it's not the problem of internet or such thing like that. It can be improved in rural areas also. So I feel that it's not at all impossible, but with the time, with the efforts taken by authorities, it will surely be possible.
Bhargavi, very good presentation. My question to you is, like, to use creativity and more so digitalization, technology, all this would require huge resources on part of the state. Now, on one hand, we are having a huge number of population which is below poverty. We need to provide them with basic food, clothing, shelter itself, and medicine, health. So in this scenario, is it possible to develop all this technology for creativity in education?
Yes. So when we say creativity, some creative activities like which don't need technology as such can be introduced to rural areas first. But as you said that we have problem in rural areas that they do not have basic needs. So yes, the difference will be there. In urban areas, more and more exposure will be given and more different types of activities we will be able to perform. But it's not that rural areas will just be ignored. Some activities still can be performed in rural areas also by not using technology as such.
Thank you, Bhargavi, for your wonderful presentation.